Hi folks, this is David Kwan here, and I'm continuing to talk about Final Fantasy XIII 2. I told you guys I had a lot of things to say about this game. Maybe I'm just saying a bunch of nothing, but it is a game that I like to talk about because it surprised me how much I ended up enjoying this game. One thing that I have a mixed feeling about this game is just the new edition of this thing called Life Trigger. So, in cutscenes, during the story, there are moments when you can choose the response of the character. You get four choices. One is like a, you don't really know which one it is, but one's a comical choice. Like, the character just says it to be comical. Some are pretty obvious, some are not. And some responses are more, I guess, appropriate than others. But it adds into kind of the replayability function of it. You know, you can go back throughout the game. You can, you know, after you beat a section of the level, you can go back to that level and rewind the time so that you're starting as if you've never experienced that cut, you know, that level before, but there's also this sense that you have. So it's kind of deja vu. So you can choose to kind of give a different response when that life trigger event happens. When you do so, the dialogue is different. It can also kind of change the rewards you get after the end of the cutscene, because you do get rewards or unlockable items and whatnot. Or not unlockable, but just item rewards. None of them are that consequential. But it, you know, that's one thing to keep in mind. You know, you get to enjoy different dialogues. It doesn't really change the overall story that much, but it is pretty cool that they included this aspect. And there is kind of an aspect of a Western role-playing game, you know, WRPG. JRPGs don't really do this that much. They, in terms of storytelling, JRPGs tend to tell a very kind of structured story. Like, this is what happens, and this is how it's going to happen. Like, the whole choose-your-own-adventure kind of thing, it's a very WRPG concept. And people who are into that are into that. Like, you know, you get to have your story be told however how you want it to go. It's a big part of WRPG. JRPGs, not as much in this genre. There are some games that do that. I guess Final Fantasy XIII is kind of, it tries to include a little bit of that aspect of it, but not that much, you know. It's just interesting to see. Like The Witcher, for example. That's a game where you can choose some story decisions, and these, and that it has a huge impact on the rest of the game, that you might not even be able to access certain areas or certain stories once you've decided on a certain course. So that's something that, you know, JRPG franchises like Final Fantasy don't do. They don't do that. And some people are like, you know, that's why WRPGs are so much better. I think either one is an appropriate choice. Some people like that the WRPGs do that. Some people like the JRPGs like to focus more on a single story and develop characters throughout that one story arc. I tend to be more in that camp. I tend to prefer linear games over open world games. But that's just me, because I do like the storytelling. I do like growing with the characters. And it's really hard to do that with WRPGs, where the game developers have to account for, what if the player chooses this? Then how do we have the character respond to this? So the character becomes very diluted because of player choice. That's what happens with WRPGs, but the overall universe and the setting are kind of, yeah, I think it's amazing. I like both. I'm just saying I tend to prefer more linear games because of the story. But that's one thing about Final Fantasy XIII 2. They do that whole live trigger thing. And I have some little notes about that I took while I played the game. The Moogle is the Moogle character is kind of a big addition in Final Fantasy XIII 2. Moogle is really annoying, but it's cute at the same time. There's also a charming aspect to it. It's a comic relief in a lot of ways, because, you know, the Moogle can't talk, but the Moogle is also the weapon, Sarah's weapon. It can be Sarah's crossbow, Sarah's staff, and you can choose different weapons that Moogles will transform into. So, very interesting, you know. And the voice acting of Moogle gets really kind of grating and annoying at times. But there is a certain part where the Moogle's backstory is delved into in this one side quest where you're doing this clock tower puzzles. Oh my god, the puzzles. I have to talk about the puzzles. I'll do that later. But yeah, you know, he does have a very interesting kind of a backstory, which I really enjoyed. Let's see. So I talked about the two characters, Noel and Sarah. I think that's just disappointing that these are the two main characters of the game, and that's it, you know. And the rest of the characters are kind of like very side character-ish type. For Lightning, I think that was a smart choice. And for Caius, you know, he's a main character that you see a lot of. And Yule is interesting. So, story-wise, I think it's great. I just don't think... I'm just really disappointed by how they did handle the returning characters of the game. Except, so, the only characters I thought were done really good in this game were Hope, Lightning, Caius, and Yule. Those four characters really done really well. But a lot of the other returning characters, it was just like they come and go, like that. It's like, oh, wait, what, oh. And as someone who's played Final Fantasy XIII the original, and actually really grew to love the original cast of six characters, that was kind of disappointing. I was like, oh, Saj, you're here. And Saj makes just like one short little monologue, and he's like, okay. And then he goes out of his way. And then you meet up with Fang and Benil, and they like appear in your dreams, and then they're gone. And then they appear at the very last sequences, just like, oh. And Snow just comes and goes. All of a sudden, he's 300 years into the future. I don't really know why or how he got there. And there's a secret ending, so there's 12 secret endings in this game. Or 8 secret endings, sorry. 8 alternative endings. And Snow appears in one of them. In 400 AF, so that's 400 years into the future. And it's like, oh yeah, guys, and he saves the day, but it's just like, what, where do you come from? How did you get here? You know, and why, and this, it just ends. So the way the returning characters are done, I think, was what's really disappointing, because I really liked Saz and Daz as characters so much, but they're given such minor roles in the story of this game, and that was bothersome. The overall story gets really dark in Final Fantasy XIII too, especially the ending. It's just like, no matter, there is this theme, there's this kind of sentiment of like, no matter what we do, in the end, the future is gonna be just messed up. There's nothing we can do to prevent the world from being destroyed in 500 years from now. And the whole premise of the game is, we're going to go back to the past, we're going to the future, we're going to change time itself so that the world doesn't get destroyed 500 years later. But no matter what they do, it's like that's what ends up happening. The world gets destroyed 500 years later. And there's this feeling of really just hopelessness. And Final Fantasy XIII originally touched on that a lot. Like, you're branded as a lessee by the Falsi, and once that happens, you either become a crystal because you did a really good job, or you turn into a monster, a Seeth, because you didn't fulfill that job. That's the only two options that you're given. So there's this option of hope, this feeling of hopelessness. No matter what we do, we're either going to turn into a crystal or we're going to turn into a monster. So, like, there's no good ending to this. Final Fantasy XIII 2 kind of twists that idea even further, saying, this is what happens in the future. We know this is what's going to happen in the future. And here are these two characters fighting desperately to change that future. But no matter what they do, they're unable to change that. And so that is a very powerful point about the story. And Caius and Lightning are in another realm where they're fighting each other, where time doesn't work the same way as a regular, you know, universe. You know, here, time goes in a very linear fashion, in a chronological fashion. You know, yesterday was yesterday, and a month ago was month ago. But where Caius and Lightning is, it's like time doesn't move. So 1 second can be 100 years. You know, 100 years could be 1 second. But at the same time, yesterday could actually be tomorrow, and tomorrow could be today. And what's happening right now has actually already happened. You know, it's like, whoa, they're in that realm. And that aspect kind of gets really just portrayed at the ending of the game, where Caius reveals to us. So I don't want to spoil too much, so I'm not going to spoil, but Caius is just like, this is what's happened. And Noel and Sarah are like, what, that's impossible. And Caius is just like, no, time doesn't work here the same way as your universe does. And so it's like, oh, that's what, oh. And so, like, you know, I think that the story kind of is very convoluted, so messy, but it actually kind of makes sense at the same time, too. And the ending of the game is just so, so morbid. Like, oh, man, like, it's not a happy ending. This is not a very happy game at all. There are some kind of joyful, cheesy, charming moments in it. But throughout the game, it's a very, very dark theme in this game. But anyway, I blabbered on a lot about the story of this game. From next videos on, I'm going to talk more about the gameplay. So the things that I want to talk about that are... I also talked a lot about things that I liked about this game. So next videos, I want to talk about some things that I didn't like as much. You know, so the puzzles is one thing. I have mixed feelings about the puzzles. On the one hand, I really like them, but on the other hand, I really don't. The puzzles are one thing to mention. The level, what was that level? Academia 500 Years into the Future. Academia 500 AF. That level design is a topic for a different video. Seriously. Alright, I hope you guys enjoyed. Cheers.